Welcome one, welcome all, welcome to the Armchair Generals multiplayer game here. This is, I guess, the second one we're posting to the channel, so we'll call it game number two as far as you guys are concerned. We're using Perfect Storm version 0.4. Let's quickly go over the teams. In this game, we have the Axis composed of Germany. Sorry, this is the Axis team, but they're not necessarily in the faction yet. Germany, Italy, Japan, Finland, Romania, and Hungary, and either Spain or Turkey. I'll get back to that in a second. The Allied team is composed of the UK, USA, France, Canada, Nationalist China, and the Soviet Union, and either Spain or Turkey. So let's talk about that. When the Spanish Civil War breaks out, we are going to have two of our players, which are currently spectating, jump into the two different sides of Spain. So we have one player for the Allies that's going to jump into the Republican side. We have one player for the Axis that's going to jump into the Nationalist side. And they are going to attempt to fight out the war. And whoever wins, that side gets to control Spain. And then we'll do a rehost because the other side is going to control Turkey. And that is how we are distributing those countries. Spain, slightly about 40% more factories than Turkey, probably a few more diverse resources, and more importantly, a bigger population than Turkey. So Spain is the prize in this case, from as far as an actual production commitment point of view. Although, theoretically, you could argue that Turkey might be more valuable to the Axis as an ally geographically. That's certainly something to consider. But that is how the game is currently set up. I'm going to put a link in the notes below here on the video so that you can check out the rule set that we're using and the mod itself. There are quite a lot of changes, including a change to political power, which is why I'm getting minus 0.5 per day because I'm researching a national focus here. Yeah. So, there we go. I'm going to leave the political power on whatever it is here. The Rhineland has been remilitarized. Let's jump back into the chat with everybody else here so we can hear what they're saying. But for now, we're going to talk about the United States. I'm going to be playing the United States, so it means I get to watch what a lot of other people are potentially doing and report on that. So here we go. All right, I'm back. I was reporting to my recording here. Hopefully we'll be able to do well with it this time. First time we tried to record the last game, it only captured my voice. No game sounds, no anybody else.
Oh, right. I remember you saying that. That's really annoying.
And then also I played like crap and I felt embarrassed to even show it. But this will be better. Oh, I've got some free military factories. Almost always, extra support equipment is literally never bad. It doesn't get old. So I'm just going to have all of it go into here except one to that.
Are you going to do a big strategic bombing campaign as the USA? Because they are pretty well set up with that, with a focus that extends their range by 50%. Japanese land.
When I played against, you did. Now that of course requires me holding on to the Philippines.
There is an island that you have already one marine on, which is still in range for the level.
Oh really? What is it? The Guam?
Let me check.
Looks like Guam. Must be the one you're describing. That's interesting.
You can hit
Japan from Guam. Crazy.
Yeah, it's Guam.
If you get the focus, I got you.
If you get the focus, and then maybe you need to spend some air experience on extra range, but I don't think it's necessary. I think when I tried it, I had like full range over the Japanese isles with my bombers, which is fun.
We are way behind in infantry equipment at the beginning. Wow. That changes what I was planning on. Let's have all the military factories go straight into infantry equipment off the bat. I'm producing a bunch of dockyards early, and then also military factories.
The good thing is you can have quite a lot of time before you need the infantry equipment.
Yeah. So I should probably have some defending forces at places like the Panama Canal and, I mean, not Alaska, though. Alaska's just strategically useless, I think. Yeah. As long as I hold Hawaii, there's not...
Most of the isles in the Pacific are also, in my opinion, not worth keeping, except Guam. I built that up with a port, usually, to level 10.
Mm-hmm. And extends the range pretty significantly.
Yeah, and it just it's a good fallback base for your navy in the Pacific. Make a nice air base of it as well for all your planes, so you can have 2,000 planes there and just fortify the hell out of it.
I kind of wish either Eisenhower or Douglas MacArthur weren't field marshals. I kind of want one of them as a general, but I only got one good general. Oh, I've already assigned the other good general. I got two good generals then. I'm going to make Clark my defensive guy, and if I need to, I'll promote him to field marshal. So I think the first thing I've got to do with my political power is hire the advisor. Do I have an advisor that gives me the... Yeah, Silent Workhorse. That seems valuable when I'm getting so little political power.
Yeah, it is.
Okay. Basic machine tools. And definitely concentrated industry. Even with the interesting things they did with retention and stuff, I definitely still want maximum output.
When the Spanish Civil War pops, can I try the hot join? Since I might be the only thing that's hold.
The Observer hot join?
No. I mean, like, I'll drop and try to hot join. Oh. There's no... I can't switch
gotcha. Anything. Yeah, because of the bug. Yeah. I mean, we've got it to work fine before. So we'll pause it, we'll save it, we'll let you try to hot join.
Yeah.
Sounds good. Needs to pop soon, though. Come on.
Yeah, the average time is somewhere around April, May, if I'm not mistaken. No, it's like 100 days after the election, which is in February. So maybe around April, May. I have one division in the Philippines. I feel like I'm going to want the Philippines to be its own little army defending it. How many rivers are there in the Philippines? There's one big river in the Philippines that could matter. All right.
Germany went west wall.
Oh, I haven't been keep track of that. Good deal.
Japan's army primary sea.
The PDF, as it's called, the Philippine Defense Force. All right. Who are we going to give as a general? I don't want to use my really good one. Patton's got to be used for my armored division, obviously. So yeah, we'll give him Truscott. He'll get some good stuff going on there in the Philippines. And actually, if this is going to be a defense force, let's make this, like, weird yellow something. And we'll make this the same color as the Philippines, or at least as close as we can get. Meanwhile, we got that going on. There we go. Now everybody's going to have that. Oh, there it is.
There it goes.
So pause it. There we go. So, hold on a second and let Innocentius save it.
Hey, he's pretty competent.
I like that name.
All right.
Make sure.
So, speed 3 or speed 2?
Let's do speed 2. We get to all kind of watch what's unfolding here.
There we go.
We'll jump back to speed 3 as soon
as... No, pause it. I haven't done anything.
Oh, God.
Give both sides a chance to take a look at their new country. We all got 5 minutes, but it's like, screw these guys.
jump back into a new country. I imagine they were in there for a while already.
I think you should have got my notification already for the volunteers. I think that went through.
All right. I think the key here is taking the Balearic Islands.
Yeah, we should also take Morocco, too.
Oh, my God. You're right. I never even noticed that. It's worth a total of 1 VP. Get it.
about most.
And the Canary Islands. Nationalist Spain got to keep a lot of tiny shit. That's not cool.
Yeah, they got all the colonies. Apparently they had a lot of support there. So I think the strategy should be first take Berlin.
Might That's be jumping ahead strategy. One step.
Well, I mean, that would teach them, right?
I agree. Take
Berlin. You sure you want to be fascist? I mean, we control Berlin. I'm not sure what you imagine to do while you're fascist, but...
So I just realized I can't... I can't watch anything that's going on. Like, oh man, I'm really excited to see what happens. Oh, I can't see anything except the borders.
Yeah, me too.
At least if you're sending volunteers, you'll see stuff there. I can't, like, can I just be temporary faction invite and then I'll go back to being not a faction just so I can see what's going on? I mean,
even if you're in the allies, you still can't see it because Spain is not in the factions.
Right. I'm used to being in the Axis, though, and seeing it all the time because they've sent volunteers to three different places.
All right, well, I think that I've done all I can.
Support. All right, Axis is ready as well. Let's go. And fight!
This is very exciting, watching this. I can't wait.
Did you get a pop-up from me?
I did not.
Oh, okay. Send it again. What? I wasn't lagging before. What happened?
Got the pop-up. There we go.
What is support artillery? Is that anti-tank and anti-air?
Support artillery is the support brigade.
No, research. Oh, let me pick first. What do we want? Might not be a bad idea to get Marines early on.
Yeah, if you at least unlock the first one, then when you do the focus for getting the Marine Corps, you will have a discount for level 2.
That.
I land on the 11th.
So specifically what I'm looking at is the Support Rock Island. 50% research bonus for support artillery and support technology.
Yeah, that is literally the research for anti-air, anti-tank, and artillery. And the support technology could maybe also... No, I don't think so.
And the Committee on Technocracy... I'm going to actually look this up in the game file since I'm not doing anything else. I can at least answer it. But look at that. By the way,
so,
France and Britain, you can jump off of civilian economy if you want.
No, we can't because we don't have the PP.
Well, once you get to it, but 8% isn't going to degrade very quick. Just save up.
Yeah, we have been saving up since the beginning, I assume.
They sent a lot of... Oh, the peace treaty... Oh, that's degraded. No, because that's degraded
right,
too.
So support technology is the support brigades, like the...
Oh, the support companies.
Engineers.
Yeah, that makes sense.
And the artillery is the artillery, anti-air, and anti-tank.
I only start with 3 research slots, so I have not been saving my political power. I really want to get to that.
I start with a focus from day one, and then I will have... enough power eventually.
I have to adjust the Italian aggression compensation. It added an extra 0.5 that I did not plan on that happening.
Is getting 25% less political power part of the mod?
Yes, it's something we're trying out for this game to see how it plays. Oh, nice! You almost that's the coast they took. North of Spain's getting cut off there. Valencia, Barcelona.
The other bad thing is Germany can lend-lease nationalists, but I can't lend-lease Republican.
Yeah, no. The Axis are in the driver's seat early on, and I think they get the edge as far as winning the Spanish Civil War within the context of this rule set. And I don't think it's impossible for the Republicans to win. Although they they basically sent the maximum number of volunteers they could send.
They sure did. All right, I'm here.
So the cost to that, I mean, you might lose the Republican, the Civil War, but the cost of that is that France and Britain are hopefully going to get off of the bad civilian economy laws.
And at least be a little bit high on the world tension already.
Yep.
There's Germany.
It looks like you've got somebody cut off in the middle there. South of Madrid. That's nice.
Yeah, there are two pockets. Three at least already.
Wow, yeah. You got three pockets. That can't hurt. I mean, they've got that big pocket in the north. How many divisions do you have up there?
Zero.
Oh, perfect.
I can't stand this AI trying to do things for me, though. I have not learned how to play this game correctly because the AI just pulls divisions all the time.
That's probably the most annoying thing about this game is you guys just readjusting along your line instead of pushing.
Yeah, if you're going to readjust the line, shouldn't you just have everybody shift down one instead of having one guy leave and go way around the outside? I don't know. I guess that has its disadvantages, too.
Run all the way to the other side of the line, take a week to get there.
There it is.
I liquidated one pocket, another pocket's about...
How many divisions were in there?
Just one, but another... Each pocket has one division in each of them.
That's not bad, though.
But in this war, you know, that's what you got to do.
Yeah. I mean, one division in this war actually makes a difference. We got three civilian factories. What do we want to do with them? I want to make sure.
The nationalists are suffering more losses than the Republicans.
Can you cut that Japan division off right there? Is there a space between those?
Actually, right where? Oh. Yeah, I'm helping you out. Let's hit the Russian army.
No, let's stick with
it. Right, he's pulling back now.
Lend-lease is the problem. I have no weapons.
And I can't lend-lease till 20%.
That's probably good.
I pocketed some more troops in Cordoba.
Yeah, everything in the south there must be running out of supplies.
Yeah, it goes really slow, so I can't freaking defeat them.
Looks like you've got... Oh, no, the troops in the northeast there, they probably get supplied through the port in Barcelona, right? I guess that would be true of the troops in the south, too. They could get supplied through Cadiz.
Yeah.
Oh, you got him.
Careful of that salient you've got going on in the... Oh, boy. Yeah. The troops in the center there just got cut off. I can add anything to this. I'm probably seeing stuff that happened, 10 minutes ago that's being updated only because units finally arrived at their destination.
Yeah, pretty much.
Almost got them broken out.
Have we've only gotten the actual...
Watch Madrid. Thank you.
The actual Spanish divisions are the ones that we're pocketing, right? I assume the
Yep, unfortunately.
Italian, German, and Japanese are not getting pocketed.
Like, we just can't defeat these cutoff units, which sucks. Oh, but we did cut off those Italians. Nice, and I just freed up two divisions.
Italians are next to Madrid.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, one panzer division.
Ooh, excellent. I mean, what the good thing out of this, at least, is that I can do the shadow scheme, which is locked up behind 5% real tension.
That's true.
Hey, the Germans motorized are going to cut me off there.
Yeah. Same.
Ugh, I didn't realize I was stuck on Disarmed Nation for so long. I haven't played the U.S. in a while.
Yeah.
What does it take? War propaganda is... Oof. Wow.
I mean, losing this war is good for our long-term strategic goals, because then Turkey's on the Allied side.
Yeah, for us, it really doesn't matter that much who wins here, I think.
I didn't actually look at my navy yet. I should start doing that. We have three carriers.
All right, if you can get any of your troops out of here, you should, because I don't think we can stop this. Even, like, the pocketed units aren't even falling. It's part of the problem.
Yeah.
This guy's fighting from two directions. He's literally losing no organization every hour.
I was gonna have these guys start training, but I'm still so far behind in equipment, I don't think it's a good idea. Man, you've been doing some good work. Oh, but they got a couple pockets in the north there, huh?
Yeah, we just don't have the weapons, so that's the biggest problem.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, they start with the 36 steel in the north there. Well, they take the 12 from you anyway, right away. That gets them the 36, and you've only got the 12 in the south for producing any weapons.
Yeah, and they got some land lease from Germany. I saw some planes as well going there.
Land lease doesn't increase world tension, does it?
I don't think so.
Hmm. Interesting.
Yeah, see, I've had this pocket here, south of Cordoba, not the Cordoba pocket, but this one south of it, pocketed, attacked by three divisions since the beginning, and hasn't even lost half organization.
That's weird. They should be suffering huge penalties to that. But it's just because you're not doing any damage, I assume. Because the like really crappy
planes and artillery.
I actually think that one thing that they do different that they should have done like they did in Hoi 3 is that when you're out of supply, your organization should tick down much faster instead of this weird 33% penalty.
Well, there's the 33% penalty, and they do take attrition when they're out of supply. But half the time they're out of supply and they're in a city, they get enough local to supply to last forever. If you ask me, the main thing that needs to happen is that local supply needs to be something that's not unlimited. Local supply should be something that goes down if it's cut off from the supply network.
Right.
So over the course of like a week or 2 weeks or whatever you want to make it, local supply diminishes to zero once it's been cut off.
It shouldn't be more than like 5 days because you need so much supply to continue fighting. usually.
Oh, I got the German.
Get him.
But no, he's going to break my organization.
Well, do your best to have the Soviet units survive, I guess.
Yeah, just pull out. It's going to be done soon. Just fighting for pride at this point.
Well, it gives us Turkey, which is also a really good thing.
Can you stop that Italian division? I'm at least make him lose that tank.
Which Italian division?
Right there, the infantry. Just halt him. All right, got him.
Listen, you guys got this. As soon as you finish off that pocket near Gibraltar, you can rush all those forces north to reinforce everything. Right? Right?
Right.
What is the state of the war here? You're still holding on. What is it? It's Valencia and Barcelona that are keeping you up, basically.
Yeah. But everything's pocketed now, so it's just kind of like...
Yeah, they could send way too many tanks and motorized.
I mean, I think it's weird that the Soviets can't send Lend-Lease just because they did in real life in the Spanish Civil War last.
Well, I set the Lend-Lease to 20% because otherwise they can Lend-Lease to China just gobs of equipment and make Japan lose every time, I think.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Although, actually, maybe that's not so bad because of the... You know, Japan could just shoot those convoys down. Now, the thing is, when I first made that change, it was because in 1.1, convoy rating didn't work, right? It was just broken.
Yep.
So now that convoy rating works, maybe I don't need it anymore because Japan can just destroy those convoys.
It would be like a house rule would be nice where Japan couldn't send volunteers.
Maybe I should just change the, where Japan couldn't send, you mean to Spain?
Yeah.
I don't know. I think, I'm going to put down here, and I'm just putting my own feedback thoughts in here. I might change the Soviet Union to allow Lend-Lease. I just don't think it's necessary to restrict it anymore because the convoys can be destroyed, and it's not like they won't be able to completely shut down Japan by lend-leasing equipment to China, because Japan starts with enough subs to just sink a lot of that stuff. And a lot of it will get through, and it'll probably hurt Japan to do so, but it'll also hurt the Soviet Union to send so much equipment to the bottom of the sea when it comes time to fight Germany.
Yeah, definitely.
So I think it's an interesting trade-off that at this point.
All right, get your armor out.
Oh, yeah. Can you stop the tank division? Just push against him. Thank you.
Oh, Jesus. Literally right when I clicked it.
Oh, the next one. That motorized
there, tank. I'm attacking both of them. You can escape. Get out of there. Nice. All right.
Thank you.
Get to a port.
I would strategically redeploy to a port. It's like run.
My Gibraltar forces are trying to help, but unfortunately they can't.
I started reorganizing my fleets like years ago. All right, let's see. So, Hawaiian division. We'll add those to the defense army. To island. Probably worth holding on to that. We'll add that to the defense army.
Germany's on industrial effort.
I just want to kill this one pocket. It'll be my greatest victory. Come on, we're so close. We did it. Yay. Well, I'm going to pull back to Barcelona. We're just gonna let him come through.
Hungary is supporting fascism in Romania.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Does anyone know the detriment from attacking rivers, the exact amount?
Minor rivers used to be 30, they're now 20. Major rivers used to be 60, they're now 40. So it's 40-20 for minor and major.
Yeah, you should, your troops at the port, can you just send them back home? I know that I withdrew them before. Pull them out to sea.
You can't,
Never mind, that doesn't work. Maybe try to attack Spain or Moroccan Spain.
Oh yeah, you want to do naval invasion of Spanish Morocco?
Yeah, there we go.
That actually could work if you had enough time to plan it. At least with the armor division, maybe.
Here, I'm getting off of Barcelona, and that's a lot of victory points.
Yeah, try.
Can I walk into Gibraltar? I cannot.
Yeah, I'm going to capitulate here at the end of the day.
Oh, there it is.
All right, pause it there, and let's save it and rehost so that the Republican player can join Turkey.
There, I can do this. I can take control of Turkey. It's fine.
Really? Did it kick you to Observer?
It kicked me to Observer, and then I clicked on Turkey, and we're good.
Perfect.
All right.
Woohoo!
Well, GG for the Axis. First victory is theirs.
All right, I'm just going to drop down and let them know that we're ready to keep going so they don't get confused. Yeah. All right, guys, we were actually lucky. The game kicked our Republican player out to Observer, and he was able to join right in on Turkey, so we don't have to do a rehost. But
nice.
Good fights. I extend our GGs to the Spanish war. And we'll head back up and unpause it.
Divisa or Liberty.
All right, so we can unpause it and go back to speed 3.
All right.
Let's do it.
Wow. Let's see how that world tension worked out. Yeah, that's perfect, actually. It only caused 0.4% world tension. Maybe that's a little too high. Maybe I should change it to 8%.
Yeah, I think it's actually fine right now. I mean...
Well, my mod added the minus 8.6. And my goal is to have it about 1%-ish. So I'm going to change it to minus 8.
But it depends on what time the Civil War fires.
Well, that's kind of correct, but remember the scaling doesn't happen until 1937. So if the only time that would change is the actual peace treaty would cause less world tension if the Spanish Civil War ended sometime in 1937. Oh, that's
which
weird.
Is definitely a possibility.
Actually, this is different than I thought I had set up in the mod. I have it set up, so I must have written down the change log and then changed my mind, because I have it, now the scaling is actually starting in January of 1938 by 1.5%, instead of in 37 by 1%. So it scales harder and faster, but it doesn't start scaling until later in the game. I need to change my change log so that it's appropriately reflecting that. There we go. Yay, we figured out how to do the Bureau of Ships.
Yeah, as the USA, you can rush towards level 4 battleships quite soon.
Hey, everyone. So I, for some reason, am just a hot bed of chromium. So it would really help me out if you... when you need chromium to get it from me. I need your factories.
Actually, now that you mention it, I do in fact need chromium. I was taking it from the UK, but you're right. You probably need the civilian factories a little more than them.
Yeah, by all means, take it from them.
We'll get plenty of other things from the UK, like rubber.
Also, if you need some steel, please, China. I have terrible industry. And
oh, geez, we need 10 chromium. Wow, whoops. So I will give you 2 civilian factories for that chromium.
Perfect. That's great. Thank you.
Hmm.
I'm going to focus on a... Wait, no, that's not right.
How close are you guys getting to the political power needed to change your economy law?
I need 9 more.
I'm not close at all.
Yeah, I'm a ways as well. I should have not picked a focus, but I really wanted the factory.
Yeah, I guess bad planning on my part.
Well, France, you get an event that gives you early mobilization at some point.
Well, you should have gotten when the Spanish Civil War broke out, I think.
It's kind of random, isn't it, if it pops up or not?
It happens sometimes.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think it's like a long time to fire, and it's only when the Spanish Civil War is actually taking place that it can fire.
I've had a couple of events playing by myself that really help you out, and then other times you just don't get it.
So... we should still be above 5% for the next, say, I don't know, year or so. So you should be okay getting to that before the 5% degrades. They threw everything in there.
Should we try to do speed 4?
Yeah. Now that the Spanish Civil War is gone, we can certainly give that a shot. All right. And I got to figure out what I'm doing with my Navy here. I think I'm just going to take Aerithite.
I think I'm going to make a force of Marines. I was like, I'm going to build mountain troops. And then I realized I don't need a whole bunch of mountain troops because I'm not invading the Caucasus.
Yeah. No?
Hooray, mobilization.
Will the Allies hate me if I take back Greece? Because Greece has got all the resources I need to really expand this Turkey.
I am the Allies, and I will not hate you.
I think in order to do that, though, you're going to need to go communist Turkey.
Yeah, well, let's get that rolling.
Not going to be able to justify a war goal against Greece until much later, unless you go communist.
Yeah, after this one... one construction effort focus, I'll go right down the collectivist to internationalism focus.
Well, notice that the collectivist, you can't go down it. Do we want the new deal? I think we do.
Better than the old deal.
I don't think I want Alf Landon.
I always like getting Landon because it gives you the industry focus exact thing.
FDR forever.
4 more years.
Industrial concern. That says 150 political power, in my opinion.
Okay, then I definitely want to get level 2 destroyers so that I can start pumping those out, because I need a ton of them. We're going to train in the Appalachian Mountains. That seems like a good place to go train, right?
As good as any, I guess.
And I am trying something new this game. I normally always go positive heroism, but I'm going collectivist this time.
Nice. Yeah, both are really good trees.
Yeah, I was able to, I think, 1937 or 38... I was able to get my unity up to 85%, so I'm figured, okay, if they're going to rush me, they're going to have to take everything.
Yeah. So
instead of the 50% with positive heroism, I'll just jack it up all the way.
And that's a good thing, because that means they will have to keep doing a lot of effort in the Soviet Union for a longer time, which gives the Allies more time to actually strike at them.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I don't think I'm going to be able to get to that economy switch. Shit.
Oh, geez, it already dropped down to 5. I'm 7.
It's falling at 1.5% per month.
No, that's the scaling. It's actually falling at 0.1% per item per month.
Okay.
So each of those volunteers is going down by 0.1% per month.
Gotcha.
Yeah, I'm lucky that I made it.
Yeah, I'm going to sit here with no focus, and it'll be 10 days so I can take it. Maybe it'll still be there. Oh, it might be, because it'll be December still.
Oh, yeah, that should be good then.
All right, Japan is going for the bridge thing.
Yep.
I think I might sneak in under this. Here we go.
Yeah, I pushed too hard for that extra research slot. I'm at 21 political power right now.
Oh, wait. Yeah, that's okay. If I get it, it's going to be on the 31st.
31st is still December.
No, I'm not going to get it. I got it. I literally, yes.
Aha.
Yeah, early mobilization.
I got to figure out what I'm going to do next. I think I'm going to get a theorist. I've been avoiding focuses so that I can get something, and I think a theorist seems like a good plan.
I'm not sure if that's actually the correct play for the USA, since the complete to the right focuses give you 150 political power each.
Oh, I forgot about those. Jesus. Yeah, political power, 150 each. But it costs me whatever 70 political power to get 150. That's not the worst thing in the world.
It's a net gain of 80. I mean, if you don't do any autofocus, why not?
That's true. I should be doing that all the time, basically. But I'd have to sacrifice the first 70 into Monroe Doctrine.
The first one doesn't give you it?
No.
Okay.
All right, I'm going to wait on that one and grab something first. And I think theorist, or maybe one of the research things, makes the most sense. I should have gotten the industrial concern early on.
Yeah, that's why I choose Langdon, because he gives you the industrial concern.
No, I still have Standard Oil of California, or doesn't say it's not available.
No, but he gives him you automatically. You don't have to spend the political power.
Oh, I see. I see. Now I understand.
That's the big upside of the Republican.
I gotcha. I'm picking up what you're putting down.
Excellent.
Oh, wow. I have a research support equipment. Well, that's starting.
Yeah, it just dropped to 4%. I'm at. Darn.
You're fine, though. You're friends.
Then we'll get back up again.
Interesting.
And if it doesn't get back up again, that's also good for us, right? There shall be peace in our time.
Yeah.
Hey, question. Can states only transfer occupied territories? Or can they, like, sell their own states? That's kind of my curious.
You can only transfer occupied territories.
Yeah, that's pretty
You can return owned states to the original owner.
That's true, too.
Gotcha.
Speaking of which, UK could return Newfoundland to me. I would be very happy about that.
Sure.
What does it have there?
It's like one factory.
Yeah, you're right. And the, Canada, and the northern one.
I can't give you control of a state if we're not fighting a war.
No, it's under occupied territories.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, it's under manage occupied territories.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I wonder if that even gets... So hang on. Before you send it, as the UK, hover over the recruitable population and find out how much of it is considered core... Like, is that only core territory for Canada, or is it core territory from the UK as well? Because if it's only core territory for Canada and it's considered a colony of the UK and non-core territory, that could be something you want to do every game, to give the full recruitable population to Canada.
Yeah, well, we'll see. So I have eligible non-core population is 79.94.
Back up over, well, at 5%, so.
Yeah, it's it went down from the eligible non-core population.
So yeah, so there's no reason to keep that, is there? Interesting. You definitely, at least with a Canadian player, I should say.
Yeah, because
the Allies as a whole get a lot more manpower out of it that way. I mean, not that there was a ton of manpower in there to begin with. You got 22,000 on one side, and no, actually, wow.
300,000
on the other side.
It's a lot, at least for Canada.
Yeah, exactly.
Germany's going Anschluss, and Italy's going for claims on Yugoslavia. Japan's going after China.
Claims on Yugoslavia, they could be starting the war soon.
They still need to fabricate those.
Oh, jeez. The Americans don't get a generalized theorist for military. They have to wait for the 250 version. Ugh.
Yeah.
And I hate the 250 version. It's so not worth it for the extra 3% speed on doctrine research.
Yeah, definitely not.
I want to edit it to make it so that it also gives you, like, instead of 0.05 experience, it gives you 0.07 or something, so that there's at least one other thing besides the 3% that's beneficial.
I love it how the German generic one actually gives a better bonus than the bigger one, because
it gives
the plus 10% armor speed or something like that.
I don't want to modify my government. I'm missing equipment production. Carrier fighters.
I'm looking forward to some of the Paradox's expansions because, in my opinion, the Middle East is way too devoid of anything. You know, there's definitely iron and steel in the Middle East, and it's just not there.
I'm going to be right back. I need to go take care of something.
Yeah, I think it's maybe because on a large scale, it would influence the game too much.
Yeah, I mean, also Paradox just leaves stuff for later for their expansions. They do that a lot. Which is fine. I pay for it and enjoy the game, so.
As long as the game's enjoyable at release, then I'm fine with that. And me having about 300 hours in Hearts of Iron 4, I would say they did a good job.
Yep. The only thing is the damn battle lines. I'm looking forward to more advanced systems where you can do pincers and stuff.
Yeah, just don't put your hopes up too much.
Well, no, definitely not. But they need like a stand ground command just because I hate the shifting of the line. If I count on like 16 divisions being in an area and then because of my success in the north, all of a sudden 10 of those are pulled up to move into the gap, then all of a sudden the enemy can just break through the south.
Yeah.
I really want supplies. Like a supply system that's better.
Yeah, and meaningful. It's kind of ridiculous that all the countries are fielding like 500 divisions.
Yeah.
And that's the thing that's really, really difficult, because look at how they did it in Hearts of Iron 3. That was horrible.
Eh, I thought the supply system was fine.
It's kind of about to be done. Oh, boy.
Is the solution to that to, like, if you put it on hard difficulty, it lowers the total maximum production efficiency, which essentially just lowers all production output of equipment. Is that the way to do it?
No, they need to make it to where if you have 70 divisions in a province like the AI likes to do, that there is astronomical penalties. Maybe you can't supply anything, maybe they can't fight properly, but it's ridiculous.
I got Vols ready for you, China.
I mean, I think the reason that they don't do that is because they haven't trained the AI not to do it yet. They're probably seeing that as a problem. They're just like, well, we'd like to take care of that, but oh, there it is.
Oh boy.
There it is.
The first big thing.
Hey, everyone get ready. Prep your political power.
Ah, jeez, I don't know. There's a lot of options here.
Actually, I really want international focus to go communist, but I've got a communist power. Oh, but there's 400 political power at the bottom of this tree. So, gimme.
Let's just start on land doctrine. Never a bad idea to research land doctrine.
Yeah, the land doctrine's huge. As the United States, in one game I played, I neglected my land doctrine, and for almost a year, my troops were useless in northern France. And once I finally caught up, then they started being wrecking balls.
Oh no! I chose Italy, poorly. I forgot I could get war propaganda.
Treaty with USSR.
That's good. They want your tanks.
You're going to deny them the awesome tanks?
You should deny them. No, you should deny them. They get, like, if you accept, they get to get medium tanks.
So do the Soviets.
The Soviets get a huge... So if he denies them, the Germans just go back to normal research, and the Soviets get a massive penalty.
But they only get it to tanks if you don't want to focus on tanks.
Yeah, there you go. It's certainly an option.
The Soviet Union not focusing on tanks. That's crazy.
I mean, the big thing about the medium tanks is that it really screws up France because they have to deal with them.
Right. Oh, wow. That was a fast war.
Plus only with the small...
We're at 15%, by the way, if you can get off of partial. Or you can get two partial, I guess.
10 more points.
Yeah, I'm not even close.
Partial is... it's got to be 25 unless you're communist, right? Yep.
Yeah.
What air doctrine do I want? Strategic destruction is the Americans, right? That seems like a good plan.
Yeah, blow.
There's a lot of good stuff there.
I want to see you destroy everything with your planes.
Fighter detection plus 10. We're going to find them. We're going to take them out. We're going to take them out. I also don't mind having a maintenance company. You know what? I got to start researching tanks. I'm not building them yet because I don't have shit to build them with, but I should probably care at least a little bit about that.
I'm just pushing out fighters and bombers.
Hey, we finally have enough infantry equipment to start building some divisions here. So to that end, I'm going to start training my Big Red 1. They're all trained, but we're going to get them to the regular.
That's kind of good. I got to war economy before Germany did.
Nice. Really? Germany took that long to get to war economy?
They're still on partial.
Interesting. They didn't have to. They just had other uses. They went for double silent workhorse. I just wouldn't do that as Germany.
Yeah, I definitely would. It's really good. And just literally start influencing every country.
I guess, but you could do that with the 300 political power you just spent on silent workhorse, can't you?
No, not at the same time. Usually you will end up in a deficit.
All right, fair enough.
In the long run, it's definitely worth it.
All right, we're just about ready to go war propaganda. Uh-oh. No, it's gone. It's no longer available. I screwed it up. Damn it. How is that the case? Oh, because Japan's not in an offensive war anymore. Damn it. I screwed it up. I mean, the only thing it would have given me was an extra recruitable population, but still...
And you don't have to take it later.
Yeah. I mean, I wound up getting political power instead, which isn't the worst thing in the world.
Yeah, but just there are a lot of things that are good behind it.
Yeah.
And just you getting it already means you get closer to those things fast.
Germany is going to demand Sudetenland.
Okay.
Japan, the student movement.
I think I want... this. And now I am going to get that equipment effort 3.
Alright, I was seeing if you were paying attention there.
Say, what?
Glorious Mongolia?
Glorious Mongolia!
Querulous, barrelous.
So, have you ever played them before? They can only do cavalry.
Really?
That's all, the only divisions that they get? The only division template?
Yep. Kind of funny. Paradox, sense of humor.
Is that at the start or for the whole game?
That to start.
Whoa, what was
war
that?
War in China.
Damn it, I just picked something else. Son of a bitch. Well, that's going to go on for a while. Who can lend lease to them? Nobody. Yes, actually, whoa, we're at 25%. The Soviets can now lend lease to China if you want, and you can start making aggressions against your neighbors if you want. Take out Finland.
Take all the neighbors.
Finland's not in the Axis yet. Go, go, go.
That is definitely a good idea.
It actually might be a hole in my mod, because they can't join the Axis until it gets to 50%, and that's probably a problem.
I dropped speed down to 2 because war's going on.
They can't join even though they're fascist?
Fascists can't join each other until 50%. I need to make
They can be guaranteed by Germany.
Oh, that's right.
See that before.
Yeah.
But they'll see you justifying to the point where they will be able to guarantee. I forgot guarantee.
But
so that does make
it. They have to remember that they can guarantee.
They true.
Do. I'm sure Expedo does. He's very good.
Are you sure? I mean, it's worth a try.
Yeah, he's very good. Okay.
Oh, you got more than huh?
Now, when will the Unified China event pop?
A couple of days in.
Yeah, because I got some volunteers ready to go to the peoples as well.
Not that. I wish I could help, but I literally can do nothing.
Let's cut.
Yeah, I'm standing here cheering from the sideline.
Japan's planes are really hurting, but we're doing decent so far.
Navy organized here. Oops, not them. So 15 battleships. Holy crap. Oops.
Man, this most eastern province on the Maginot Line can be attacked from like 5 or 6 provinces, it looks like. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Holy crap.
Yeah.
Almost want to build land forts at the airport right behind it.
Yeah, it's definitely not a terrible idea to have like a fallback line there.
Usually, though, human players avoid the Maginot Line because any competent human player can just cycle up the troops. And they'll just take astronomical equipment casualties.
Yeah, it's still nearly impossible to take.
I'm hoping they're coming straight through the Maginot Line, though. That's got to be their plan, right?
No. Yeah, it would be a great meat grinder.
Yeah, he would. He's probably gonna go. If they go after you, he's probably gonna go around Maginot. Yeah.
Oh, for sure.
Man, organizing your fleets is still a giant pain, right? Once I get it organized, it's fine, but ugh.
Oh, I'm glad I don't have that with the Soviet Union.
I have a problem adding newly built ships to fleets that are already patrolling.
Yeah. You have to make sure that you have it set up properly. Dang it.
Where's that event pop up? I wonder why you're not getting it yet.
All right, that's what I want. Merge.
Oh, there's merge. The train.
Merge. Okay.
Yeah, we really need that unified event.
Yeah, Well, at least I arrive on the 28th. And there we go.
Hello.
And you can't use support equipment, right?
No, I haven't reached this one.
Okay. Do you want planes? Oh,
well, nice. Yeah, and that would really help, yes.
Okay.
Because Northern China's not having fun.
Alright, one light cruiser and a bunch of destroyers. Seems like an okay plan.
Let me give you some convoys as well.
Alright, I'm getting the uniting events now.
Papa Stalin, helping out.
Hooray.
Thank you very much.
No problem. Oh, what? That's crap. Dang it. Hold on. Apparently, I can only send two volunteers to peoples.
We don't have any, like, Wolfpack guys, huh? So, yeah, my subs aren't gonna have commanders for the moment. Maybe I'll just give them some regular commanders, I guess.
Yeah, the silly AI in Turkey, took, as its first thing, a military theorist.
Generic military theorist? I guess it's not the worst thing in the world, but...
But I mean, like... When he could take, he could take better laws, or he could add like a silent workhorse, or a captain of industry.
That's not done yet.
I mean, you might be able to just overwhelm him with waves of troops.
Yeah, we're pushing back pretty well right now.
That's although, awesome.
Landing in South China is very, very...
So we got a port there.
Two of the Yorktown class, and they're going to go.
I'm heading in the north. Do you want me to go down south instead?
Yeah, I think we're okay in the north right now. Could you help me in the south? Because my infantry are pretty terrible at attacking.
Crap, I forgot what the difference was. Is the Yorktown better than the Ranger? Crap.
Hey guys, just a quick strategy call. Is which one's more vital to divisions? Engineer companies or reconnaissance companies?
I would say engineers.
Especially on defense.
Alright, good. Because that's what I picked, and then I was like, wait, I never got any input 30, on this. 15, 10.
Yeah, I think actually Yorktown is the superior version. It's the variant, now that I think about it. Okay, so yes, Yorktown is good. And this will go to Naval Group 2, and we only need one of those.
Ooh, is there a little space there in the north?
Almost. I gotta see what's going on over there. I haven't checked in with the war because I've been working on this nonsense.
Looks like Japan's pushing in the worthless territory area of China.
Huh. Yeah, they haven't even started to take Beijing? Really?
There's a bit. There's a battle going on there for forever.
That's not going.
They didn't do any. Oh, they did a naval invasion in the Click. That's where they're focusing too.
Yeah.
It's not a bad idea to keep them their two invasion points really far from each other, so that the Chinese can't ever easily push from one to the other.
Beijing's about to fall down. Yeah.
All right. So submarines are doing what they're doing, light cruisers. All right. So what are my fleets missing now? Well, they're missing commanders.
Oh, they have volunteers of the wazoo.
Oh, yeah. Definitely. But he's really spread out, so that might help us.
Yeah.
And I mean, China should just be able to spam militia.
And East China is a bit worrying, but there's a bunch of mountains there, so hopefully that'll keep them back for a while.
Can you guys, what is Germany doing?
Perfect.
It is doing demand Sudeten land.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, Italy's doing Pact of Steel.
Oh, can you push up on the south there and cut off that one Japan?
Are you guys going to support the Sudeten land, or are you going to let the
I'm
Czechs...
I'm going to let it go through.
All right.
You should support Sweden, I think.
I don't think we'll have enough to stop Germany already.
Well, like, if you force Germany into war with Czechoslovakia, it means it's only 1937. They're not going to be that prepared, and
it'll help me get in the war faster.
Well, that's also true. Then it's pretty much up to France. Like, do you feel comfortable in a war?
We got him cut off a little bit, but he might be able to fight out of it.
He's trying not to. That is
right. Okay, so they're kind of like rolling through the mountains over there. It's probably not that big of a deal, but.
Can you attack him in that little pocket?
Yeah.
Look at that glorious national unity. 85%.
For the Soviets?
Yes, sir.
How?
I went collectivist.
Oh, that's right. The plus 20 from there.
That is a really good balanced choice.
Yeah. That way, if he attacks me, he's going to have to take everything.
All right, so last call. I can oppose the Munich conference. Yes or no?
No, nah, let him have it.
I would have it.
Yeah. Oh, you went collectivist propaganda? Yeah, I always go collectivist.
Man, but
normally I go positive heroism.
I like going positive heroism because it's got that socialist science, which recruitable population 3%. That basically allows you to go to total war economy and cancel each other out, which is pretty awesome.
Yeah, there is something to be said for both sides, because especially their plus 10 production speed is really good.
And I can keep Tukhachevsky.
Alright.
Ah, shoot, they get another port.
I gotta rename these so that they're not...
You guys got that one pocket.
Yeah, there was just two divisions in there, though. Still positive.
Did it rename these? Yeah, good, perfect. Oh, this is supposed to go Atlantic. Yes, okay.
Germans are just rushing VPs.
Oh, yes, he is.
War propaganda. Woohoo! Did I ever get that one deployed in Virginia? I did not. It's still training. Alright. I gotta finish my damn Navy before I forget.
Okay, in the south pocket, can you attack those two Japana divisions? I'm going to try to cut them off and race to the port.
Which two?
It's like to the far east of the... Yeah, yeah, right there. Perfect. See if he notices.
Nice, you guys. Oh, and you got the German Rampage and Spearheads under control, too.
Alright, I've got four destroyer groups, a main navy for the Atlantic, a main navy for the Pacific, and two subgroups. I think I'm happy with that. Though I might wind up using both the Atlantic and Pacific navies in the Pacific, we shall see.
Yeah, if we eventually have pretty strong naval dominance, I can switch my navy to protect your Atlantic side.
Yeah, it depends pretty entirely on what we have to do with the Italian force. I feel like if you and I combine our forces on Italy after we destroy the Italian navy, then I can send my full force over to the Pacific.
Yeah, and I expect that the Italians focus on the German side first, actually. And otherwise they will just be caught in the Mediterranean.
Soviets, they've got, they've connected, the...
Yeah, they broke out.
Yeah.
Do I have things that give me land experience anywhere in here? Must be.
He might get that.
Problem. Yeah, there are a couple, but they're pretty far.
Ugh, that's
you guys need to worry about them taking Communist China's capital.
Arsenal of Democracy gives the biggest boost. It's 50.
Yeah, it's just so far away. That's why I'm exercising my troops like crazy.
And you get 10 from the USACE project. But that's also pretty
pocket them.
Yeah, that requires 80% world tensioner to be at war. Ugh.
Military construction gives another 10. And that's already doable.
All right. So these guys are actually already full-on trained. But if I don't keep exercising them, I won't get nearly enough army experience to edit the plans that I want.
I'll be right back.
Yes, I need to get to isolation. Oh, that was a mistake, not getting to that sooner. The last time the Japanese started that war. That'll free up so many civilian factories.
Bridger, is this your first time playing USA in multiplayer?
In a multiplayer, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, that's always rough if you forget isolationism because you're just sitting there waiting.
Well, no, it's that I missed the other option before isolationism.
Gotcha.
The WPA. I didn't realize it was tied to the war, so I grabbed something else instead, thinking I could come back to it. And then the Shaanxi War ended, and I was like, what? But I'll get isolation next.
All right, now I just need to get my my level up to a sufficient, and I can do a coup and become communist.
This base infantry division isn't bad.
Nice.
The real question is, do I want to go integrated support, or do I want to go dispersed support?
Whichever is the one that gives you the line infantry, line artillery bonus.
I was thinking that, but...
Because it's so much better.
Yeah, it is. So let's edit up our divisions here. There we go. And that means we're going to need to produce a lot more artillery. Oh, and we definitely... Oh, we... Did we already... Wait a minute. Oh, motorized is considered an infantry thing. Interesting. But that absolutely needs to get a bunch. So 37... Japan, oh man, despite my buff to the Chinese basic equipment, they're... Well, you know, they're taking the shit that doesn't matter, I guess, huh? They're still going to have a hard fight going for the stuff that does.
Oh, yeah.
Eastern China.
And they got stalled pretty hard down in the south there.
I mean...
More infantry equipment?
As long as... I mean, if China just keeps holding on, they can keep churning out... groups of infantry that just get in the way.
Yep. And let me see. I want to make sure of one thing.
And China hasn't even fallen back to fighting along its rivers. So.
Yeah, the fact that they haven't taken that whole Beijing sector in the north until just now certainly helped out, because there's a lot of factories up in Beijing that the Chinese were able to use for quite a while here so far.
I'm sure they still can. They control most of the province. Or most of the state.
No, but the victory point value is what matters. Because Japanese got Beijing, you can see that Japan is now the state owner.
Gotcha. That makes sense.
So 25, then 40% is the next big thing for me to care about after isolation is taken care of. So the Germans are getting the first Vienna award, so they're going to grab... Or that's going to divvy up more of Czechoslovakia, right? Probably give Hungary some.
Yeah.
And the Italians are doing Pact of Steel to get into the Axis. They did claims on Yugoslavia a while ago, but they haven't used it. I wonder why.
Yeah.
Because they needed it to get something else. That's right.
Oops. They needed it for getting Pact of Steel towards that.
Mm-hmm.
But if they didn't want to claim Yugoslavia, then I would have guessed they would befriend them?
So what do I have for air units in the reserves? Very few planes. Oh, those are out. Huh. That's the other thing I should do, is make sure that each of these... Yeah, for some reason... Close air support on a... Maybe I don't... I don't think I want close air support on most of my carriers. You know, maybe one of them.
Usually I'm with naval bombers and fighters. That's all I want there.
Yeah, but if you want them to provide some kind of support to the land battle, but then again, there's not much they can do. Even if you put half of them as CAS, they don't do too much. All right.
No, that's absolutely not worth it. Saves researching and saves production of that as well.
True. All right. So we have fighters of 28. We do 27. Fighter. Oh, it's already at 28. So this one's actually correct. I wish your carriers didn't start with, like, not a full complement. That's a pain.
Anyway. Yeah, that's a really strange thing. I don't understand why.
All right, so all my carriers are now properly set up, it looks like. Now I just need to be able to build the things that go on the carriers. And for that, I need way more military factories.
Finally, the Turkish elite marine divisions have been trained.
Hooray!
Soviets, can you take care of that German tank gun towards Chongqing and...
Yep, I'm cutting across the river to cut him off, and then I'm going to attack him.
Alright, thank you.
Oh, it's an infantry division. Even better.
All right, let's go back and take a look at what's going on in the war here. Man, the People's Republic are hanging in there. Yeah. That's really tough to fight in.
Yeah, good job, China.
But why did the AI pick an air safety expert? They have zero planes. You spent your political power on an air safety expert. They didn't build any. They've actually got one or two decent, like, military staff they could have put in there for their ground troops, but they picked an air expert. Guys, it's okay. They're also going for close air support effort as their... What?
Yes. AI.
Jesus.
I'm really curious what the heuristics for that are.
I don't think they exist beyond pick a random one with the weighting that we've put in. And by the way, we only put in weighting for, like, the major countries. But I mean, it takes a long time to deal with the AI on all of these levels. It just, it could take a day to fix all those kinds of problems with one, you know, tree. And then you have to go back later because you realize you didn't take into account everything. That's why when people go, oh, her, look, you know, after the Netherlands has already fallen, you can see the United Kingdom taking the focus to help invade the Netherlands. And you're like, her, look at these funny bugs. And it's like, yeah, but you know, some AI programmer somewhere like slamming their head on the desk like, oh, I forgot that one condition when it shouldn't be takeable. Is if Netherlands doesn't exist, because you got to put in every possible condition of game state that could affect the decision, and it's a nightmare. That's why I gave up and said, no, listen, I'm just doing my mod for multiplayer. this is way too much time being spent on this stupid nonsense. Yeah, so it looks like China's hanging in there.
I want to go a bit south, though. The eastern China push is getting a bit close.
You're not Burgundy.
I mean, worst comes worse, you should just be, like, throwing out groups while they're green and just get them to the front.
Yeah, I don't really have the equipment for that.
Oh, yeah, damn, they do have to have guns.
Are you sending them equipment from the USSR?
Yes.
It's getting through? I wonder if Japan doesn't have any submarines patrolling? It would be coming from all the way around Archangel, I'm guessing. Because for some reason the Soviet Union says, hey, this port over here is closest to Moscow, so let's send everything through that. Actually, St. Petersburg, right? Leningrad?
Yeah, probably.
Like, I tried to get some things from the Soviet Union as Japan, and it's like, look, we're next to each other. Their border touches mine, and it's like, nope, gonna ship it to you from St. Petersburg through the English Channel. Like, god damn it, I'm at war with the British! Pick a better route, okay? We'll send the ships over to Vladivostok. You just send it on a train. I want that to be fixed in the most extreme way. I kind of wish you could set your own supply routes, or at the very least if they made them slightly more intelligent.
Yeah, you're doing actually pretty fine in China.
Yeah, he's just got that southern pocket that's a pain.
Yeah, the drive in the back door, though, seems to be pretty strong. They just took Chongqing. Does the British, do you have any access to the Burma Road?
No, not even close. Because I went completely different things.
Gotcha. All right, I can finally select prepare intervention and get rid of the awful, what is it, undisturbed isolation.
Okay, see north of Chen, you got those three divisions there next to the German division?
Yeah.
Can we connect our lines? See, I'm moving a mountaineer across. Yeah, if you can attack him with two and then move up with one, maybe he'll probably notice, but just in case.
Who needs civilian factories more, France or the UK?
France.
I will send you a factory. I need to rubber.
Thank you. I'm...
Hey, Germany here. Eastwood, that's not okay. I see two Soviet tank divisions.
Yes. Yes. I sent one to People's Republic.
No, yeah, you can only send one total.
Yeah.
One total?
Yes.
Ah.
I mean, I would have sent another division too, but I wasn't allowed to.
Well, you only can send to Japan, but you outnumber us still.
Yeah, but
he can send to Japan and Mankuko.
If I try to pierce you. Yeah. We sent to Mankuko and just entered.
Is it possible to recover? I'm going to pause it real quick. No, possible? Okay. For the purposes of evening this out, if you want to send one to Mankuko, Germany.
No, we can't. We are completely maxed out on
Oh, on Mancuco. Okay. Well, Eastwood, pull that division off the front lines and hide it somewhere.
We aren't. Oh, okay. So we are allowed to send one more. We can send one division to Japan. Okay.
So yeah, just so everybody knows for the future, one armored division, period, not per country you send it to.
Oh, it's not per country? Okay.
Nope.
Okay, but yeah, it fits that we just got a new volunteer division ready. Okay. So good to know this. Okay, see ya.
All right, I will unpause it. Tisk, 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 Eastwood.
Ah.
Yep.
Germany is doing fate of Czechoslovakia. So that is about to disappear. Hungary's great again. Just so you know. He's probably going to split Czechoslovakia with Hungary now that there is a slight advantage to doing so.
Yep. I wonder if Romania will give Hungary the northern Transylvania.
That's an interesting question. I don't think it's a good idea because I don't think it's going to count as core territory for Hungary.
Yeah, I'm not sure about that. I mean, I thought logically it would count as core territory.
I think it requires there. I think if it did, it would show up as like a core flag on the foreign claims thing, right?
Yeah, yeah. That's so, true.
Okay. And I think it's Germany that decides anyway, if I'm not mistaken. 12th of February. So, man, I'm getting a military factory every long time.
Can you attack that division with your horse just to hold him? He's going to cut off my mountain. Just south of People's Republic. Yeah, thank you. And we'll cut him off. He's going to try to save his infantry.
Yeah, free trade.
Oh, you guys took John Quinn back.
I wish I could send my obsolete equipment to China.
He's not winning that battle north of Chen Gongqing, is he? Or however you say
it. Ooh, you took Chongqing back, huh?
Yeah, that worked.
Nice. He still can't get through Beijing. He doesn't have any offensive forces over there. He sent all of them into eastern China. He's got to have hell for supply lines over there, right?
Yeah, I think so.
They also have to be suffering on their equipment. If they're fighting in all these places at the same time.
Yeah, not only fighting, but moving through those places must have hurt their equipment a lot, because just moving through mountainous terrain is high attrition. 40% attrition just moving through it. They still haven't gotten the People's Republic out. They could get rid of, like, 20 divisions if they could do that.
Yeah, but they can't, apparently. Maybe because they focus so much on the south and the...
Yeah, I mean, it might wind up working for him if you see the south and that other one sort of link up.
Yeah, exactly.
That'll work for him.
But that's not happening at the moment.
Yeah, the south, that bubble's not expanding very fast. That's good job holding on to that. But still, if you wind up holding Nanjing and that whole coast up to Beijing together all to the end, you're going to be a lot stronger. I think they made a mistake not taking that industrial core from you.
They're going to take Beijing now.
Well, yeah, they did just take Beijing, but it took them a long time. Like, the war was going on for 2 or 3 months before they got Beijing. And it's literally on the border. Like, they should take that right away.
Yeah.
What's more important to Marines, having support artillery or having engineers?
Engineers.
Yep.
Pretty much no question, I think.
All right, awesome. Oh, yeah, breakthrough.
Aha.
Huh, interesting. Hungary is supporting Japan through land lease, but they have no legal transport path.
Huh. So they're trying to lend lease. Oh, that's Ugh, that's another thing.
I don't think the Axis have noticed it either, but they're actually not able to send anything. And Spain is sending them basic equipment. Basic infantry equipment.
Yeah, that they don't want.
Does anyone have any spare political power? If I mean, wait, is it against the rules to influence a player if they want it?
You can only influence a player in the way that it's stated on the faction thing. So what do you want? Turkey to go more communist faster?
Yeah.
So the Soviet Union could help you out with that. That is legal.
Okay.
If you have the political power. If not, I'm just getting close now. Usually at 40%, you can trigger a coup. I'm at 32. I want to be communist before I switch my economic law so I can go straight to war economy.
I do want that eventually. I don't know if I want to use the 50% on it, though. That's too far.
Thank you.
No worries.
Oh, maintenance company also got added, huh? Oh, it's added to all the support. But not these. That's interesting. Yeah, I think maintenance company is going to be more valuable to me than military police.
I got that one division cut off.
Soviets, do you have any spare infantry equipment? I have 13,000.
All right.
Thank you.
No problem. Cutting off that Japanese division in the south now.
So Desert Wolves just disconnected.
Oh no.
Perfect timing. I gotta use the restroom.
Haha.
Nice.
All right, I guess we'll see if he can reconnect. I disconnected from Discord as well, it looks like.
I've made a save in any case.
Just a heads up, it looks like Desert Wolves disconnected.
He had to leave early.
Oh, he had to leave early, so we're just going to keep going?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Apparently Desert Wolves had to leave, unfortunately, so we're going to keep going. But let's wait a second, I guess, for whoever goes to come
what
back.
What country was he playing, actually?
Hungary.
Oh, right.
So, not the super most important country in the world.
No, exactly.
We rehosting?
Yes. Desert Wolves is actually had to leave.
Yeah, so we can just continue onward.
I'm surprised.
Oh, he left?
Yeah. We're about 30 minutes away from the end of the session here anyway, so should be fine.
Yeah. Yeah, so we can just keep on going.
Keep on keeping
on. Yeah, I don't expect World War to start this session.
Eventually.
Our first ever Armchairs game, it started right away. April 1937.
How did that happen? Did you see? Oh no, maybe it is retreating.
Yeah, I remember the first game that we started. We were done in an hour or something like that.
In the first Armchair game where we had no rules and it was just we were all Luddites, but. The UK invaded the Netherlands because the Netherlands was going Axis, and that kicked everything off.
All right, the RTS are a bit different. I was thinking of the Stream Team game that we had.
That one ended much faster, yes. You're not
because
wrong.
I joined the armchairs really, really late.
Did you still talk to Kane and...
No, never heard of them again. I'm not sure if they're still doing YouTube and streaming things at the moment, actually.
Yeah, I still have you and Kane on my subscribe list.
Yeah, I'm not doing much at the moment either.
I need armies training all their stuff. Let's go.
I need manpower, like, really.
I need to be communist so I can help out China.
Oh, that's right. When you're a communist, you can help out China.
Yeah, but things look like they're getting worse.
Yeah, things are getting pretty bad here.
Are you just so out of equipment you can't really go on the offensive?
Yeah. I am 20,000.
Oh, God.
Yeah, the thing is, let's see. Japan's got Germany, Italy, Romania, Hungary, Spain as volunteers. But it's just me right now helping out. So he has more than... two tanks, because each one of those is sending one tank.
Yep. Well, I don't know if Spain's sending any tanks.
Maybe not Spain, but definitely Romania. Hungary, I think, has one to start out with, maybe. Maybe not. Yes. They more volunteers.
China's very close to falling.
Wait, you were able to... Oh, okay, if it's not aligned, you can go down internationalism focus.
It's on the verge of collapse, really.
What is China?
Yeah.
Yeah,
he's breaking through in the north. They're going to push towards Nanjing.
Oof, yeah.
Yeah, that's curtains.
Guidance, what you
but
see.
You can always join me if you want to, China. I could use the co-op.
All right, that works.
That's typically what we expect is China or France... is going to switch over to some co-oping on some another ally's faction.
I would have been better off without without the uniting China thing, because the new front in Zubei's Ma is a big problem.
Yeah.
You
got to move there quickly, and it's rough because there's so many mountains and everything.
Yeah, it didn't occur to me now that we've got essentially two extra Axis groups that can now send volunteers. Huh. And the allies
that I added
was Canada and Turkey, and they, well, cannot. That might be something we have to adjust, but I don't think there's something I can do in a mod. It might have to be something I do in the...
Well, I think a house rule that just volunteers need to be related to your theater, because it makes no sense that Japan's sending to Spain, and it really makes no sense that German and Italians are in China.
Well, on the realistic sense, you're right. I think we just need to say something. I mean, the house rule could just be that minors can't send volunteers.
Yeah, that would work.
Right. Because that way you could still have Germany and Italy sending and the Soviet Union sending, and they usually balance each other out. That's why it's always worked out really well, because Soviet Union usually sends, five to Spain, and between Italy and Germany and Japan, you usually get about six fascists coming in. So that's going to have to be part of the rule set for the future.
Or you can get something like three countries per faction so that you let them choose which countries you want to send some volunteers so that you don't just focus on the main countries.
That is possible.
Oh, Japan just naval invaded.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't have the...
Oh, on a Nanjing. Oof.
Damn equipment.
So that's collapse.
Yeah, I think the simplest, you know, the sort of KISS solution is just miners can't send volunteers. Boom, done.
Yeah, sure.
Because by the time Canada can send volunteers, it's already probably going to be in the war. And by the time Hungary... Well, Hungary's the one we're trying to prevent from sending volunteers.
Yeah.
So that's for future games, yeah. In the meantime, maybe we can get Turkey to go fascist fast enough, but... So you got the proletariat revolution. Did you get your claims from that or a core? I'm not sure if... I don't think I've fixed that.
No, it's kind of broken. It gave me... It says it gives me claims on... actually, no, I do have a...
you have a claim on Tibritz, but not a claim on Mosul. That's weird. So you got a claim on Tibritz. Did it give you any others?
It gave you one on Bulgaria.
Yeah, so I got Bulgaria and...
Ah, okay. So it did give you two, which was the goal.
Yep. Ooh, I was hoping I would get Syria as cores, just because that makes a lot of sense for the Ottomans.
Yeah.
Or the Turkish, sorry. Not the Ottomans, the Turkish.
Modern-day Turkey still claims that, actually.
Yep. There's a lot of issues.
So yeah, once you flip to communist, you can start invading Iran or Bulgaria. Bulgaria actually has just two aluminum. So if you want two aluminum, go for Bulgaria. Although Iran is actually going to be strong enough to maybe resist you. They only got three divisions.
Actually, they,
three divisions, Iran.
I'm going to be invading Greece the moment I can. Because they've got everything I need. I've got the neighbor.
Iran has a lot of oil as well.
I've got what you need. Oh man, I'm so close to getting off this awful economy law. So close! I can taste it.
I'm so close to getting some manpower. Just 60 more days, then the war to end all wars will be gone.
Yeah. Next time, it's probably better not to unite China.
No, I mean...
If you don't, you don't get access to the good resources in the south.
Yeah, and they can invade them easily.
Right, if you don't unite China, then they can invade them one at a time and just pick them off.
Yeah. It's not helping you much because...
I don't know, you might be right. It's tough to say offhand.
The uniting of China really scared me because I didn't have any garrisons in the Guangxi clique and the East China mountainous area, and that really extended my front.
Yeah, and I think letting them take that small country or that small faction, what is that? Shaanxi,
something.
Letting them take that early is not too good. Because that just widens the front in the north there.
Military construction gives me some army experience and a bunch of military factories in New England. I will take it. Although now I'm going down in political power. It's okay. I want it. I want it a lot.
I have 400 political power, and all I want to do is become communist.
You know, communism next to godlyism?
Yeah. We want to join our Slavic brethren to the north.
Navy primacy.
Do you have a Black Sea fleet?
Yes, I do.
Eastwood? Awesome. I might need that come my invasion of Greece. I don't know if my 14 ships will do it, or 9 ships will give me supremacy to invade.
Invade where?
The main thing is just you go over land, right?
What?
The main part of Greece will still be a land war.
Well, if you take Athens, it's 20 victory points, and there's only 6 other ones. And then I have 10 divisions in the north driving towards
Thrace.
Thessalonica. So, I mean,
true.
I think it might actually fall after Athens, but if it doesn't, I've got naval invasions to their other victory point.
On Crete?
Yep.
So keep in mind that I'm almost positive every province is a victory point by itself.
No, I don't think so.
No, it's not.
I'm pretty sure it is. If you take all of the victory points in the Soviet Union east of the or west of the Urals, the only victory point of any note they have left is Vladivostok. And that's 15.
There is like groupings of provinces become a victory point, but not every province is a victory point.
Yeah, the Soviet Union, it would make taking the Soviet Union impossible. Because
what it already is. If the Soviet Union's at like 90%, even after you've taken hundreds of victory points in and around everything west of the Urals, the only that they have maybe, I don't know, 20 to 25 that are east of the Urals, but they have hundreds and hundreds that are west of the Urals. And you still have to, and you still actually, this is the key, you can cause them to capitulate without capturing a province that's listed as a victory point. We actually tested this in Poland by just capturing everything, like when we just did the non-AI test between me and Simo. We were taking over provinces that didn't have victory points listed in them, and eventually the capitulation percentage went up after we captured three provinces. So they are each worth one victory point, but the concentrations of victory points are on top of what each individual province is worth. I'm almost positive that's the case. If it's not that, it's something like they're worth half a point each or something, but it definitely makes it hard to capitulate the Soviet Union if they have 80 or 90%. Even if you take all of their everything, even in and around, like, if you cut the damn thing in half and take everything to the west, for some reason you have to keep going all the way into the east to capitulate them. It's a nightmare.
Yes,
I'm pretty sure it's the lava thing. Because right. I'm pretty sure that if you have a group of provinces, that constitutes to a victory point and not every province itself.
It might be, maybe a fraction of a victory point, but they're definitely not all listed.
Because I've read on the forum, I think, or something like that during development, that groups of provinces still become...
Or maybe each state is worth a victory point? So whoever controls the state might gain a victory point automatically in addition to whatever victory points are individual provinces. That could be.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Because there are plenty of states over there that would add an extra, I don't know, 15 or 20 VPs to the whole Siberia area if each state is also worth a VP.
How close are you to capitulating?
Still quite far. 81%.
Hold on as long as you can. So if you click on the world tension at the top and then go to the current wars tab, you can actually open that war and look at the capitulation.
Yeah, I'm using that to keep an eye on the number of revisions that Japan has.
Today I learned.
So how much did we bleed the Japanese? 100,000. The Manchukuo is so useless, it only lost 800 people because it didn't fight. But actually, you only lost 5-1 against them in terms of casualties. That's actually not that bad. So he's got 22-27. Dockyards, and I've got 35 dockyards, so I think I'm probably okay on dockyards after my current ones finish.
Yeah, especially because the US Navy starts ahead of the Japanese one, and you're expanding faster than he is at the moment with more dockyards, so you should be fine.
Yeah, I've got 4 dockyards on subs, 10 on light cruisers, 10 on destroyers, and almost 15 on carriers once these are finished.
Are you going for carriers?
I'm just going to make sure I have 4 carriers in each of my fleets, and then I'm going to switch over to building heavy cruisers and battleships with those slots.
I really, really, really like battleship. They are amazing. And especially since the USA can get level 4 battleships in 39. That's really powerful.
Yeah, because they do get the big boosts with their to production and everything. With like the
Bureau of Ships, 50% reduction of research for battleships as well. If you go battleship primacy,
destroyer production cost 10%. I probably want escort effort pretty quick.
Yeah, it's also really good.
But first, I think the next option is going to be to grab one of those political power spots.
That's the problem with the USA. Low. You want everything.
Yeah, you're
all
not wrong.
All our promises are so good.
So, did Germans do the fate of Czechoslovakia already?
Well, he's running through it.
He must not have. He's doing demand Slovenia now.
He's doing demand Slovenia.
Oh, he's trying to divvy up Yugoslavia. Do you guys
want
to resist that?
Yeah, but I would just say no.
Yeah, don't let him have that.
I would definitely not give them Slovenia, because that gives him the option to trade Slovenia for Poland or something like that. Oh, no.
You're thinking of puppeting Slovakia. The Slovenia is the piece of
Yugoslavia.
If you don't protest that, they get to then divvy up all of Yugoslavia without
intervention later, I think. I will definitely say no to that. There's not that much of a downside to me.
Well, this is going to get interesting.
So, yeah. All right, I finished maintenance company. What do I want to get next? I got the armor. I should probably work towards weapons 2. We're getting close to 1939. I got to be ready to start switching over to weapons 2. Wow, we are not producing enough motorized at all. Oh, I need more of everything. I now finally have 22 military factories, which is like 20 short of what Germany starts at. France, I've caught up to your military factories.
Very nice.
They're trying to make that pocket. If you can attack those guys, I'm going to cut him off. See how he's moving back. Yes, you're in the right spot where you got those two divisions and then one division at the bottom. He moved.
The next one's going to have to be battleships. All right, let's get back over and see what's going on in China. Yeah, 5% more of the victory points. Where are the big ones they're going to be going after? I mean, Chengde is hiding out there, but you've got scattered ones along the rest of the interior here.
Yeah, they will just not focus on victory points, but just push the front forward.
So, China, what's your situation now with... did you upgrade to Infantry Weapons 1?
No. I have been on basic infantry the entire time.
Yeah, you kind of have to, because if you switch over, it drops so much in production.
And he's struggling so much for weapons as it is.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Japanese attacked a lot earlier than I expected.
Yeah.
We almost got that one division cut off. Or no, there's two divisions in there. There we go.
Where'd you cut them off? Oh! No, wait a minute. I don't see the cutoff. Oh, there. It's, look at that.
Yeah. Two divisions, but still, they have to...
Everything counts.
Suffer for it.
Everything counts. Just remember, be like Gandalf. You shall not pass. Okay, well, maybe if we break the bridge.
I thought you meant die and then come back stronger.
Yeah, do that.
intentionally die, too.
All right, so the Philippine Defense Force, huh?
We're going to come back.
Where's the Philippines capital? Oh, it's Manila. It's right there. Okay.
Switch me over. Come on.
Do it. Do it now.
Can I stage a coup on myself?
I'm not sure. You should. Hey, me? This is a coup.
Yeah, stick him up.
Not so fast.
I have so much political power that I'm just doing nothing with, just waiting.
Well, I could use it if you're not using it. Just put it on some ships and send them over here.
Just a bunch of bureaucrats on transport.
Yeah.
That's how it works, right? That's the reason why you need 150 political power for most things. Just send enough guys over there to actually force the guy to take the job.
I think that's obviously true.
I mean, when 150 bureaucrats gather in your front garden, then you eventually will say, fine, I'll take a position. Same goes for the focuses. It takes 70 bureaucrats to actually make the coffee to make them do something so they can take the focus.
That's true.
Once they've done one thing, they can never do more.
See if we can improve our heavy cruisers a little bit.
All right, we got Nanjing back.
Wait, really?
Yeah.
Nice.
Keep fighting.
This is the comeback, hopefully.
I'm cheering you guys on. That's awesome.
I mean, if you can push the world tension to 50 before you capitulate, we could send some extra aid.
Yeah, do that.
30,000 equipment. No.
Come on, flip. Turkey, you want all the glorious fruits of communism.
There we go, that should work perfectly. And then after that, we'll put some battleships in there. How many do we need? How many heavy cruisers do these navies need? Quite a few. Let's say two each.
Turkey's got a lot of space for factories.
Yeah, actually, that'll work.
Hooray, we finally have some manpower.
There he is. You at least fought and held them up for a long time.
Yeah, and hopefully cost them a bit as well.
Yeah, and you know, all the time that they're spent microing their troops, they're not planning ahead. They're not.
Okay.
Yeah, definitely true.
and I do not have enough industry to equip all my divisions with artillery, so I'm creating a upgraded infantry template so I can have like one army with infantry and artillery.
Yeah, that's useful.
Well, the four divisions wrapped up.
Nice.
There we go. Things should go exactly as I planned.
Okay, see how we're attacking those four divisions just west of...
Yeah. All right, just to...
One across to meet my mountain here.
I'm going to say no to Slovenia, which will make Yugoslavia join the Allies, just so everybody knows.
Ah, okay. Do it.
Yeah, do
it. Are you ready to send reinforcements to them right now, though?
No.
Okay.
I mean, if they go to war, then Yugoslavia will fall, but at least it will be occupied territory, and they will be at war with us, and USA will be able to join the war sooner, etc., etc.
Yes. Tito,
and then I can sit and volunteer.
Our only hope.
Also, if they go to war, all the volunteers in China will go away.
That is true.
Ooh.
They got my mountaineer.
I think that this means war.
I don't think they will declare war for it, but...
It did... I can't remember what that decision does. Does it give Germany a claim? It doesn't look like it did.
It gives them a focus, the complete focus for going to war for Slovenia.
Oh, they gain a focus already for it?
Yeah. German Reich has war goal against Yugoslavia to take Slovenia from Yugoslavia.
Yeah, okay, so it gives them a direct war goal rather than a claim. Like, it gives them a claim on Sudetenland, and it gives them a war goal when you refuse the Sudetenland, if I remember correctly. All right, military construction. Awesome.
Now they're just doing air innovations, what?
Yeah, Germany just pulled a bunch of guys off the Western Front, moving them over there.
And I don't see any... Romania or Finland doesn't have troops along their border.
Hmm.
Which is kind of interesting.
I mean, Finland is still not in the Axis. You could still take it.
Yeah, he would just guarantee it.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
He'd definitely guarantee it as soon as they noticed.
Yeah, if it wasn't Expedo, I would definitely try.
Oh, by the way, Romania is also justifying on Bulgaria now.
Uh-oh. He's going to take your core.
I know, what an asshole.
When does your claim for it come up, or?
Romania still needs like 300 days.
Oh.
Whereas you can justify a core much faster, but not until you're fascist.
Or communist.
Communist is what I meant to say. And you're getting buffed also by the collectivist ethos and the daily communism support.
Yeah, I'm just kind of stuck here. Well, actually, no, I'm at 44%. Yeah, I mean...
It goes pretty slow for a while, though. Yeah, I'm not sure I like how hard they crank it down when it gets higher, but, I mean, it kind of does make sense it had to have some diminishing returns.
I think the speed in which you transform your nation from a democratic to a fascist or a communist nation is good. It shouldn't be any faster.
No, definitely shouldn't be any faster. Oh, I can start building carrier fighters of the variety that actually makes sense.
The not inter-war fighters?
Yeah, the ones that are not inter-war fighters, exactly.
Damn. Every time I think that China is, gonna capitulate, they just keep holding on.
The fact that you keep holding on to Nanjing is important.
Japan's taking casualties.
Alright, so air support is the thing about Kaz. Interception detection?
Be right back. Gotta go to the bathroom.
No worries. I think it's already 12.
Yeah, we're going to have to pause it here, right?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I was hoping nobody would notice.
I would actually be up for keep playing, but I have another engagement. I've got somebody coming over in a few minutes.
Yeah, so I will make a save.
Yes, and I will as well. We'll drag everybody up. Guys, it is 1 o'clock. We're going to call it and save it here, and we'll pick it up next week. But if we could all pop up to the other channel, I would like to get a quick address.
Sure thing.
Okay.
Oops.
You confused them by moving the
X. I did. I didn't mean to move the channel. I was trying to click myself. Is there anybody who has a problem shifting the game forward 1 hour from 10 to 1 my time, Eastern time, to 11 to 2 Eastern time?
So what's that we start 1 hour later.
We would start 1 hour later and end 1 hour later.
Okay, 1 hour later. Yeah, that's fine by me.
No issues with that? Because we've had a couple of requests it'd help out people in various locations, especially the west coast of the U. The west coast of the U.S. is getting up real early. So we'll do that next week, and I'll make sure that when we put out the notification for it to remind everybody. It'll be at 11 instead of 10 Eastern time. And I'll put the it's almost time for thing as well for...
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, thank you, guys.
Well, one thing I wanted to add. The thing with Czechoslovakia is a little bit bugged because we went for sharing it with Hungary, and the Hungary player left.
I thought I saw you do that.
Yeah, he left, and the game says it's still played by a human.
Oh, so,
because I said AI should take over. When he left, I waited for a bit. I made a save, and then I clicked on the accept to let an AI take over.
Okay.
So you think that flag might still be sitting there on the Hungary player, and the AI didn't actually take over?
I mean, it could be.
I did change the Fate of Czechoslovakia event, so maybe I screwed something up and it bugged. I'll have to go double check just to be sure. I could have sworn I saw you taking Fate of Czechoslovakia, and then it was still there, and I was like, what happened?
Yeah, I mean, we took it, and then, I looked at China, went back to Europe, and it was still alive, and I was like, wait, that's not okay.
Does anybody know the tag for Hungary?
It's not H-U-G. Or H-U-N, okay.
Just load it in.
I will load it in a single plane.
I just did that, and the event is popping up right away. So.
Oh, okay. Oh, so as soon as we start the next game, it'll allow us to split it up, theoretically.
Yes.
Good to know.
I'm going to check. Why would that... I mean, the Hungary AI obviously didn't kick in, but I got to guess it's going to accept, right? There should be 100% acceptance there. Like, the AI isn't... Like, if the Hungary player doesn't show up next week and we log in and the Hungary AI rejects it, it's like, what the fuck?
But that's done something different in the whole game because that's something that Paradox did.
I know. I agree. Let me see here. Mod files... Perfect Storm.
Anyway, guys, been fun. See you next week.
Yeah.
Yeah.
See ya.
See ya.
Yeah.
See ya.